Hi, I'm John Furrier with theCUBE Pod. We are here in Maui, Hawaii for the ACTAI Global. Dave is here, serial entrepreneur. DeckBird is the company. Big part of the show here. Appreciate you being part of the team here. I'm first time here as well. We're both learning how to kite surf.
Yes, I did.
Thanks for coming on the pod.
Yeah, thank you, John. Thank you for having me. I did just have my first kite surfing lesson yesterday. It's just wonderful, yeah.
The community here is very chill, but they're very smart, right? So it's a great venue to get in and meet folks. I've met people that I never would have met before here. And it's like a smart networking / intellect, problem solving, world problems. It's a huge aperture, and the reach of this community is global. And super impressed with ACTAI Global. DeckBird, you guys are a key part of this event. This is not your first rodeo in starting a company.
No.
Talk about your background, then I want to get into DeckBird, some of the cool things you're doing with AI, because it has a global impact.
Yeah, absolutely. Thank you, John. I mean, just to your point, since I got here, the people I talked to, you know, people flew in from Singapore, from South Africa, all over the world. And the ideas and the stuff they are doing, it's just, you know, very fascinating.
You guys, so your last startup was a big company. Talk about your last success.
So the last company I did is event registration and the payment platform in China. Now it's growing to be one of the largest platforms in China. Mm-hmm. We do probably ₩1 billion in ticket sales every year. So that's my first startup.
A lot of transactions.
Yes.
We talked about it last night. I did a podcast with a company out of South Africa. They're doing OLTP, open source. And what was the motivation for DeckBird? What was the genesis of the idea?
Absolutely. DeckBird is actually one of the things that came out from COVID. I would say the good things, right? Yeah. It was the tail end of the COVID, right? I was stuck like everybody else. Yeah. But still, you have to do lots of online meetings and online calls. So after repeating myself over and over again, you know, I said, it's got to be a better way to do this with AI. So that was an idea. And then fast forward 3 years, now we have users in almost 73 countries worldwide. Almost 10 languages.
Talk about the AI product. What is the product? It's an agent, so it's got some value. Yeah. Talk about the product and the problem that you were solving.
Yeah, absolutely. So DeckBird is a little tool, AI agent, that transforms everyday PowerPoint or pitch decks from static files into self-running webinars by adding AI-powered voice, video, and user interactions. So the idea or the problem we are solving is, for a lot of the companies, the PowerPoint or the deck is
nobody likes PowerPoint.
Yeah, nobody likes it.
It's just like the worst.
Yeah, exactly. when you send it without any narrating, when people see it, you know, they look at a few pages, it just goes right into the garbage, right? People don't read it. However, though, I think the PowerPoint is still the centerpiece of any sales and marketing company. You know, the first thing people always say is, you know, send me your deck.
Yeah, exactly.
So with DeckBird, the problem we're solving is, if you look at the life cycle of a deck, there is a designing aspect of it, but that aspect has been, you know, solved by companies like Canva, like, you know, Microsoft, PowerPoints, and a lot of the AI-generated tools as well.
Yeah.
But downstream, you have, how do you narrate your deck? How do you share your deck? So DeckBird is sort of solving
this problem. We've all been in that position, David. It's like, hey, who's going to lead the presentation? I remember back in business school, and even in undergraduate in computer science, no, I'll present. You're not as good as me. Narrating the presentation is the story.
Absolutely.
And you're seeing success now with like Notebook LM is a great example. I mean, I wrote a white paper the other day, I thought it was pretty damn good. 4 pages, very dense content. I think Notebook LM, it just tells the story.
Yep.
Is that the kind of vibe you guys are going with here?
Yeah, absolutely. I mean, I think there is a saying.
I mean, that's audio only, but.
Yeah. I think there is a saying that, you know, John, the reality is actually created and perceived only through a narrative. So the narrating is actually very important. Yeah. You know, when you have your voice or your video guiding your audience through, that just makes a huge difference on how your audience will receive and perceive your company and your product. So that's what DeckBird does, right?
You're taking static data and narrating it.
Yeah.
In this case, it's presentation material, it's potentially sales material, stuff for go-to-market, could be recruiting.
Yeah.
Could be anything.
Yeah, absolutely. We have applications in a wide range of industries, right? Sales and marketing, for sure.
Yeah.
Your company deck, your sales deck. But we have lots of applications in real estate, right? People are selling, you know, houses. The first thing they want to do is to make a good presentation. Training, you just mentioned, that's actually a very big market, right? Employee training, customer training, customer onboarding, financial services, you know, you're selling an insurance product. So any scenario where you have, you know, somebody have to explain something to somebody else, you would need a tool like DeckBird.
Yeah, I mean, I think, you know, I remember back in the day, I'm old enough to remember that I used to work for IBM and HP back in the day, and they had great training programs. And they had the laser discs, the self-service training. Go study the, you know, how to deal with tough personalities, social styles, all those good things.
Yeah.
Those soft skills.
Absolutely.
Yeah. Computer-based training has been around for a while. Where's the generative AI making an impact? What's the big breakthrough in your mind? Is it generative? Is it more contextually relevant? Is there more data sources coming in? Can you just share your vision of how this progresses?
Absolutely. I think the generative AI is going to play a big part of it. But on the other hand, I think generative AI, we kind of see the playing field, the competitive advantage, and also the evolution path.
Yeah.
What I think something that's more interesting is what I call transformative AI, which is taking what you have and add to it, make it much more powerful, and transform it into something that is more effective, more personal, and more sort of quantifiable. So that's sort of what DeckBird is doing.
What's the coolest thing you've done with DeckBird AI? Because I'm sure you've seen a lot of scenarios where you bring something to life. Can you tell a story of where it's kind of like, hey, that was unbelievable, what a surprise. Was it like the human characteristics of an actor or a person? Was it the voice? Was it insights? Tell a story of something cool.
Yeah, absolutely. So I'll just use my own example, right? And also one of my clients. DeckBird also, you know, needs to do the pitch deck. So our own pitch deck is narrated with DeckBird AI. The cool thing about it is I can record maybe a 10 seconds audio of my own voice, and the deck will speak in my own voice. The advantage of doing that is I don't have to go through it repeating myself.
Yeah.
And if I find something is wrong, I can update the script. I don't have to re-record it.
Yeah.
I can just update the script in real time. When we first started, the voice cloning wasn't that good, right? You upload your audio sample, the audio.
I got a lot of audio samples with theCUBE.
Yeah, yeah.
I can get a lot of voice out there.
And then it came out, you know, it's kind of 60%. But now when you record a 10-second sample, it came out almost exactly like your voice.
Yeah.
And I think it's going to get better and better and better.
How do people know it's real? And this has become, a deep fakes, we all know, cheap fakes is just editing. But there's real value in this because it's the classic example. We've all been in that situation. We get the same question over and over again. I just wish I had a tape recorder, hit play, answer the question. That's what you're doing in some cases, but adding more flair to it with presentation. The webinar thing, I can see great ROI for corporations.
Yep.
I mean, webinars are a big part of the B2B landscape or just any company about tutorials, information. Is there a authenticity, like seal of approval?
Yeah.
How do people know it's real?
Absolutely. I think, John, I think you hit a very important point, which is how do we know AI is trustworthy, right? How do we know the content is real? How do we know the people behind it is real? That's why I call DeckBird AI really it's transformative, right? It's taking what you have built already, right? You generated the deck, using Canva or some other tools. Mm-hmm. Our tool sort of transform it. We don't really add anything sort of generative, but we just add on top of that. We go through each slide, summarize it, right? We record your voice, so it will speak in your own voice. Mm-hmm. You can have a video. All that element just bring another layer of authenticity to the presentation.
You know, the hot trend, Dave, is reasoning, multi-step agents. We hear the term, you know, one-shot answers versus multi-step reasoning. Reasoning is throwing off more token demand. Obviously, we cover that a lot on theCUBE. But is there a reasoning element here where you can get feedback and learn? Because a lot of times I use notebook LM to test how bad my presentations are, because based on how they narrate, I'm like, oh, that's terrible.
Yeah, absolutely. Actually, on the back end, we plug it into LLM, such as notebook LLM. So we get advantage of whatever LLM is sort of progressing. So that's number one, the reasoning capability. And another aspect is, in addition to the LLM reasoning, we build in a little feedback loop so that our agent is monitoring how users are interacting to the presentation and also get the data so it make it sort of more engaging.
Awesome. Well, I can't wait to try the product. And give an update on the status of the company, where you guys are at, size, funding levels, goals. What's your focus?
Okay. Well, that's actually one of the reasons I'm really looking forward to be in this ACTAI Global, because as you know, ACTAI Global helped launch two companies that I admire very much, right? One is Canva and the other one is Zoom. And those two companies have something to do with presentations.
Yeah, and transformative.
Exactly. They are transformative as well. So for DeckBird, I'm really excited about the future of it, just based on the customer feedback.
And product shipping now?
Of course. I mean, it's live in 73 countries already.
How many countries?
73.
All language-based?
10 languages.
That's nice.
Yeah,
that's hard.
Absolutely. So it's live. And we have a very small team, less than 10 people.
Yeah, that's the new startup mojo. You don't need to have hundreds of people with AI.
No. I think we live really in in an amazing age, right? Yeah. All the resources are there. So the next step for us is actually just build a product, get the viral aspect of it, and then go to market.
Dave, it's really great to know you, because you know this event is a multi-entrepreneurial, multi-time founder environment, diverse. You've got athletes here, you've got people operating at elite levels. And so as a multi-turn entrepreneur, you got to love this environment, because remember when we started companies before, you'd have to get the funding, build the product. Now you can build the product, get into the market, then get funding. A little bit different cost structures, more leverage, operating leverage with technology. Services gets better. Everything kind of gets better. You don't need the huge staffs. As an entrepreneur, what's your reaction to the current market situation? And for the first-time founders out there, how good do they have it?
I think, you know, now is a great time to start something, either in AI or some other areas, precisely because what you alluded to, the resources are there, you can get something up and running, you can go to market that much quickly. So for the entrepreneurs, I wish them, you know, all the luck. And this event is just wonderful.
It's funny, I've seen all these waves of innovation. As I get more and senior in the industry, you know, I love the market. I feel like I'm 18, 23 again, because it's so exciting. But back in the other waves, they weren't as transformative, where old and young can actually come together. Back in the old days, it was like the old folks were like, get off my lawn, or I walked to school in bare feet in the snow, like those war stories. Because it was hard to build computer science back in the 80s and 90s. Now it's a melting pot of experienced and young computer scientists and engineers and just creatives, because the tooling and the ability to build software is much different. That's
absolutely
a huge advantage, one, for staffing, and two, for more opportunities.
Absolutely. I think the landscape really changed. I still remember my first startup, I have to literally carry a big server, a Dell server, right, into a data center. I mean, literally, I did that.
Command line in, security guys looking over your shoulder, even this part of the network. I mean, it was really tight.
You don't have to do that now, right? Just on that small note, you can see the whole startup ecosystem is very different.
Well, Dave, great to chat with you. Thanks for coming on the pod here, short abridged version. It's a special appearance of theCUBE here in Maui as part of ACTAI Global, where leaders come together in a micro community, of course, connecting all together with NYSE Wired and theCUBE, bringing you all the action. Again, just all the conversations together, come together, help everyone out in the open. That's our mission, and we hope to bring more of that to you. Thanks for watching.